Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, I am going to do something that I have wanted to do for a very, very long time. I have practised this before, but I'll talk about this later. So I've wanted to do, on this channel, a pencil sharpening, or pencil crayon sharpening nail. So many years ago, I entered a competition in Las Vegas, and whilst researching the theme and what to do and everything like that, I came up with this design. I'm talking probably, 15 years ago, maybe longer than that, I can't remember. I'm old, memory is not what it used to be. So yes, we're going to do it, and we're going to do it a little bit better, I think. So first of all, I'm going to work on a tip. If you were doing this on a natural nail, you would sculpt out a white nail extension, very thin. So what we're going to do now is make sure we have a very thin layer of mega white on this nail. Because all I want is colour. I don't want it thick. This reminds me of school and my good old days at school. I loved school.
Is that because you had to write lines all the time?
No, that's not why it reminds me of school. I loved school. Did you like school, Adam?
Yeah.
There's a lot of people here that they just don't like school.
There's certain aspects of school I didn't like.
There's certain people that I didn't like. Yeah, that's what I mean. Like the people that bullied me at school, that now try to friend request me on Facebook. Block. I think I looked very different at school then. I think you did, didn't you, Adam?
Yes, I was. A lot thinner.
I was a lot thinner. I was a lot thinner and a lot more ginger. So because it's quite thin and it's flat, I don't really need to do much work with it really. You can, if yours is a little bit lumpy bumpy, you can just file that and make it nice and smooth. Because then it's the next stage. I'm going to take the navy pencil crayon, and I'm going to really sharpen this. Now don't get rid of those, you need to keep them. So you want to keep the sharpenings and all those little bits as well. But I needed that really sharp because I'm going to do the lines on the paper. And I'm going to offset them as if the paper's not straight. I don't want to do it perfectly straight like that. It'll look a bit crap. And you're just going to do faint lines like you would get on a lined paper. And the crayon draws really well onto the acrylic, to be honest. I won't give a margin. If you don't like one of your lines, you can dip your brush in your monomer and you can use that to straighten up your line, or you can even use it as a rubber or an eraser. I might just do a little bit of writing as well, but I'm going to do it in different colour. We're going to do it in black. So I do want to keep the sharpenings of this as well. I'm going to write the date. What's the date? Should we write the date or no? I'll write my name. I'll write my name here.
K.
Oi. And then I put Kirsty loves MJ.
Actually, that's a good idea. KM.
KM loves MJ.
Yeah.
Let's
put a heart there.
Yeah, we're going to do red heart. So these are the kind of things I did used to doodle, to be honest, when I was at school. Because if you didn't know me that well, I'll tell you. I love Michael Jackson. So I'll put it. Where should we put it here? I want it to look like it's been done at school. I don't want it sort of completely perfect. It's sort of like that. You don't want to. Because you didn't have time to make everything perfect at school.
Just in case you got caught with the teacher.
And then I'll think, do my, do the M, the KM in pink, purple. Don't forget, save all your sharpenings. Oh, dude, I hate that. I hate that when that happens.
How long is it since you've done that?
Well, I scored it in the desk at school. No, I never did that, honest. I never did that. So what I'm going to do now is select a few sharpenings. Definitely going to select this one because I love when you turn this over, you get this colour. So we're going to cut out a little bit of this. I mean, you could break it because it will break easily like that to get your little piece, but if you want a certain part you could cut it. So I need these to now adhere on to this nail. I'm going to put clear acrylic down . Take a piece of sharpening, press it in. Get a bit of backing paper, you can always secure that down while that sets. Then we're going to add the other pieces in exactly the same way. I'm going to put a little bit of clear over the pencil writings. So anything that I've written, just going to put a little bit of clear over them. I want to protect them. And then what I'm going to do with a damp brush is just pick up some of the shavings from the pencil. You want to press those into wet acrylic. You kind of just want to scatter them. One thing that I didn't like about school was the mess that pencil crayons made. This is why I have makeup that you just twist up. I don't have makeup sort of pencils that you have to sharpen. Because it drives me nuts. Like, who wants that everywhere? And who's got time to be putting that in the bin? Not me. Right, now I'm going to encapsulate all of that in clear. Now I'm set, it's all set now. I can file the nail. Once I've filed it, I'm gonna buff it and then top coat. Once I top coat it, you'll see the design shine through the acrylic. Because obviously right now, you can't really see it all because it looks cloudy. And clients kind of look at me weird when I do this, if they've never been before and they've never really had design work done before. And I put the clear acrylic on and they go, but it's all gone down now. I'm like, chill your beans. Everything's going to be fine. As soon as I put that top coat on, it's going to shine like a star. So what I'm going to do now is top coat. I mean, ooh, look at that. Oh, look at the difference when you put a top coat on. Oh, I really like it. Something different, a little bit cool, back to school nail. Brings back some memories. Some good, some not so good. No, pretty much all my memories of school were good. Apart from the bullying. That one too.
Detention.
I think my Alicia would like to have a detention because she just likes school. She'd like to just sit there in school. I don't think it'd be any form of punishment whatsoever. However, she is terrified of getting a detention because she's never had one. She's scared of what could be. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. All the products I've used today, apart from the pencils, because you can get pencil crayons from, you know, anywhere, pretty much. But everything else, nail-related, will be listed below. As always, don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Enjoy school. Be good. You don't want a detention.